Hi everyone, how's it going? Tim here, and today I want to talk a bit about Ghost Recon Wildlands closed beta. So I got access to it, and you know, I played through it a bit in single player, a bit in co-op, and sort of have a first impressions of it, and they are not quite very good, let me put it this way. So if you don't know, Ghost Recon Wildlands is an upcoming Ubisoft co-op tactical shooter. I mean, you can play it single player as well, but it's sort of aimed at co-op. It's the next game in the Ghost Recon franchise, as you might have guessed. And yeah, there you go. There's my guy. So you get to create it before you start the game, actually. And you will get a team of four AI partners if you play alone, or you can play in co-op with your friends, which... basically, for some reason, if you play alone, you will have four guys, and if you play together with someone, it will be just you and the players you are with, and the four is the cap. We played together with a friend of mine, so we were only two, which was a bit weird. I expected us to have like one AI partner each, or you know, something along those lines, but that didn't actually work. But yeah, so yeah, Ghost Recon Wildlands is a tactical co-op shooter. That is, by the looks of it, it's actually done on the same engine as was used in Watch Dogs 2, which, you know, it's quite nice looking. It has very nice detail density, and it's a lot of like very nice details here and there, and the draw distance is quite high, and you know, the night, like when you fly in the night, it looks quite amazing. The problem with this engine is that even on my hardware, which is, you know, I recently upgraded my PC, so it's now GTX 1070 and the i5-660-00 a bit overclocked, I cannot get consistent 60 FPS. Like, whatever I do, it doesn't matter what I say, I still get 50 FPS plus minus, I don't know, 5. There's some fluctuation all the time, I don't know why. But yeah, so let's talk about the game itself. So obviously it has some like performance problems right now, but you know, again, this is beta. Although it looks like those performance problems might not go away because Watch Dogs never fixed them completely, at least for my setup. I don't know what's up with that. So the game. The closed beta features this tiny slice of gameplay, which is just this one area where you have to kill the first lieutenant of this syndicate that you have to fight for. It's actually really cool that, you know, you can zoom out and actually see the whole tree of the syndicate. So your target is this El Sueño, who is the main boss, and to get to him you have to kill all of the guys around here, and some of them you don't know anything about, so you have to actually investigate and get intel. Which is, you know, it's kind of cool. I mean, if I show you the map, it's actually quite huge, so this is insanely big. I mean, even this small bit here is huge, so actually driving on a car from here to here will take a long time, so it's actually better if we try to find some helicopter or something along those lines along the road. But yeah, you know, gameplay-wise, there is a big problem with this game. So if you take Far Cry 4 and add a 4-player co-op instead of 2-player co-op and make it a tiny bit more tactical and add a third-person view of it, you will basically get Wildlands. Like, okay, the map is completely different as well. So this is like, the map is really well made. This is one of the positive points of this game. But there is literally nothing new over the Far Cry franchise in here. Like, you have skills, which is basically unlocks, that are actually boring as hell. Like, there are some unlocks that are interesting, like this, for example, grenade launcher attachment. So you can unlock it to attach the grenade launcher to some of the assault rifles, which is kind of cool. The next levels will basically just increase the grenade count, and that's it. And then most of the other upgrades are really boring numbers, like damage increase 20%, increase ammo capacity by 25%, 15% spray reduction. There is even things like, you know, I was like physical, so what was it? Where was it? Let me just wait a second, I'll try to find it. There was like a very fancy name for it. Yeah, for example, car shield. You would think, you know, this sounds really cool. No, it's just 20% damage reduction. Quiet running. No, it's just 10% noise reduction. It's like, come on, guys. You could have done something more fun with it. Train rebels. 5% damage increase from rebels. I mean, that's just not exciting. I mean, come on, seriously. This is like boring. Like the definition of boring, basically. So the way you acquire skills is that you have to acquire the skill points, which are awarded for missions, or you can just pick them up on the map. If we go to the map, you can see that, you know, here's one lying around and there's another one. You just go there and pick it up. There's like literally nothing required to get it. And then you need to get some resources that you spend as well for the skills. You can gather resources as well, just walk around the map. But the easiest way to get them is to do side missions, which award you like a few thousand of resources at once. So let me think, those boring upgrades are boring. Let me think, baby drone, no, there's just like, again, night vision for drone, that might be interesting. Okay, so drone range is boring, parachute, I already have it, C4, thermal vision might be nice, so, and then C4, I don't have 1 point, okay, yeah, so diversion grenade, why not, let's get diversion grenade. So yeah, those, you know, it's kind of disappointing to see such plain upgrades in most of the cases. Again, 10% increase in efficiency. Like, why is this is not? I don't want to spend my points. I don't want to spend my time grinding for that. And like most of that stuff, like, okay, grenades, C4, all that kind of stuff is cool. Parachute, this is great. So you can actually, like, you know, jump out of the helicopter and then parachute down. Everything else is just plain out boring. I mean, seriously. You have a loadout manager. You have a nice loadout manager that you can change and fly. So in addition to just customizing or changing the guns, you can also customize them. So there's a whole bunch of parts here, and you can collect the parts mid missions. So they will be like dropped around the different places. So yeah, we can, the parts do change stats, but they, you know, that part actually is very similar to how the division was done. Except Division had the Diablo-like RNG system, while this game has flat numbers, basically. So before we go, let me just tag some missions. So we got here side mission, blow up one of the station entrances, deactivate first antenna, is there something closer? Yeah, this one looks, stop the gasoline convoy. Convoys are a pain in ass, actually, if you don't have a correct gear for it. So let's go over there. But yeah, you know, it's sort of, comes down to the fact that the game actually doesn't have anything new, and like the shooting is solid. So again, if you played Division, you'll probably know right away how exactly it will go, because it feels very similar, or Watch Dogs 2 again, because it's the same, I think it's the same engine, I won't say for certain, but it definitely looks like it, because, you know, it behaves the same way, it has the same graphical issues or performance issues, so to say, and I mean, it looks gorgeous, so I won't take that away from it. The vehicle control is wonky as hell. I don't know what's up with that, but this is like Mafia 2 level of bad, basically. It's not nice to drive in this game. It's not nice to, especially not nice to drive motorcycles, because they behave just insanely bad. It gets a bit better if you use controller, but, you know, then it's not very nice to aim and shoot with a controller. So it's like I still play on a keyboard. But yeah, the vehicles behave terribly. Helicopters are very hard to fly straight, at least. And especially when, you know, you play in a co-op and one has to fly and the second guy has to shoot from it. That's very hard to pull off and doesn't feel rewarding. It just feels like you were struggling with the vehicle all the time. Which is kind of disappointing, you know, you'd expect an open world game, like huge open world game like this, to have a good vehicles, because, you know, this is kind of, you're going to be spending quite some time driving and flying and riding around, basically, right? So you want to do that on vehicles that are fun to ride, but sadly that's not the case. Okay, let's see, how far are we from that thing? 1.8 kilometers, let's not drive off the cliff. That would be unfortunate. Oh, I can see some buggy there. That should be more fun. Let's go grab a buggy. So as with all Ubisoft games, this one is chock full of activities and side quests and things to discover. So here's we have a base with some, so this red stuff means that there are enemies over there. and there's a Humvee with a machine gun, so we can actually go and take that. But before we actually do that, so there's a guy, kill the camp commander to make enemies more likely to surrender. All right, so I tagged almost everyone. Once you tag everyone, the red areas on the map will just disappear, actually, so that's a nice convenient way. I mean, the UI is actually well made, so it's quite easy to know what's going on and to properly tag everyone and prepare your assaults correctly. So I think I've tagged everyone now. I have my sniper rifle, and unfortunately there is no way to sort of hold the breath or anything like this with a sniper rifle. And you know, there's no like simulation elements, as for example, if we take like sniper ghost warrior, there's like you have the durability of suppressors and stuff like this. Now in this game is just like, yeah, okay, now you go in, you just either put suppressor on or not, and then you just shoot everyone and you are done. And this guy is in a helmet, so let's not attack him yet. On the medium difficulty, which says that this is the way the game intended to play, I actually found it way easy to just murder everyone. If you just don't stick your head out too much and sit in a cover, you can just shoot everyone in the face. And, you know, it won't change too much if you like do it stealthily or you do a front assault. You do die very quickly in this game. Come on. So you have to be kind of careful. Come on, why? What the? Okay, I guess the tree is in the way, so I'm just gonna go up front and murder him. But yeah, the combat is kind of tactical-ish. I guess if you would play on a higher difficulty, you would have to be more careful. There we go. That guy's dead. But on a normal difficulty, or I don't know, veteran difficulty, I think it is, you are not to say invincible, because you do get damaged quite significantly, but you know, you can just walk up there and shoot most of them. Oh, what? Where is it? Oh, that's the... Yeah, there we go. Yeah, I mean, as you can see, you know, if you're not careful, you will get mowed down. I just wanted that Humvee. So I think my AI companions can actually revive me. That was way easier with a non-AI companion. So when you can actually just go there and, you know, ask your friend to, hey, like, I'm dead over there, just revive me, please. There we go. There's the last guy. Okay, now we can take the Humvee, and this is why we actually came here. But yeah, in general, the combat is, you know, it's not sort of the tactical shooters, it's still arcadey. It's a bit more tactical than Division, for example. Oh, there's a helicopter. Let's take the helicopter, that will make our route way faster. So it's more, definitely more tactical than Division because of the nature of the Division. You know, it's not a tactical shooter, it's an RPG essentially. But it's sort of, it's very, very, very arcadey, so don't expect anything fancy from it. So let's get on this helicopter, wait for our guys. The companion AI is okay-ish, so it's like, it's not terrible, but they won't grab any, you know, awards for being the best gaming AI ever, because sometimes they just like doing dumb things, and they are made in a way that basically, even if they just go out and run in front of you to find cover, and they run in front of the enemy won't actually notice anything, which is kind of, I don't know, a bit disappointing, I guess. Come on, I'm holding shift, fly up. Oh god, that's trees. Oh god. Yep, time to bail. As I said, choppers control very oddly, so yeah, that didn't quite work out. We will have to probably grab a car over here. I mean, I want to show you the mission itself, because, you know, this outpost I just cleared to get a hammer, well, that's basically how most of the missions look. You go in, you clear out all the guys, and either you... God damn it. He just drove off. Okay, you, stop. Get out of the car. I don't think you can actually make him. Oh, you can make him get out. Okay, that's not bad. There are some interesting mechanics in here, but way too few. And, you know, I think, again, there's not enough differences between this and... did they just teleport inside of the car? I guess they did. So I guess I cannot just not wait for them and they will just teleport to me. Yeah, so there is basically not enough differences to justify another game, in my opinion. it could be fun for a bit. Again, the map is huge and there's a lot of activities, but it's all the same all over again. Okay, we're actually here. Exit it and we're gonna go there. Again, you know, the question is basically, do you like games like this? Do you like the open world Far Cry 4 like, or Far Cry like, I guess, activities? Would you enjoy doing the same stuff over and over again? If the answer is yes, then you probably should pick this game up, because, you know, so far it looks solid. I mean, okay, the physics of cars are wonky as hell, but, you know, that's not a too much of a big deal, because most of the time you're anyway going to be walking around. There is a fast travel, by the way, so you can just teleport between the locations and walk wherever you want to. So the main question is, like, would you enjoy shooting like this? Would you enjoy all this sort of semi-tactical, let's call it this way, shooting approach with either your companions or with your friend? By the way, playing with friend is way more fun, because you can stick around and do stupid things, and that, you know, that's kind of always fun, and definitely always more fun than playing with dummy AI companions. Right, so we it looks like there's nobody outside, actually, so that's... I have thermal vision, if I remember correctly, so let's try to use that. Vision mode, so where's my vision mode? It doesn't seem to toggle anything. That's a bit disappointing. Okay, I guess that might be broken as well. So, blow up one of the station entrances. How do I do that? Okay, this is my command stuff. Now, here's the question. How do I switch my weapons? This is my vision. Oh, I actually have thermal vision on myself now, but not the boat for some reason. No, this is grenade. I mean, I guess I can use grenade and just throw it here, right? That should work. Yeah, there you go. I have some grenades. I guess after that, the enemies will come out and I will have to find them. Is that how it works? Hack the network relay. Okay, no, I have to go in, actually. And they will maybe assault from outside. Oh, God. Okay, let's not die. I have 40 more seconds. Yeah, that looks clear, I think. No, it's not. There you go. And that's basically it. Yeah, cool. So I can hack it. Hopefully I don't get one get... Where are my guys? They're just like outside. Oh, I got a vehicle drop off from the rebel support. So yeah, once you do those side missions, you will get a local rebel support, which will allow you to do different things. Like, for example, I can do this mortar shot. So if I do that, there will be like, no, please don't go there. No, that's a very bad idea. Yeah, that would be a mortar shot that will just destroy everything in range. And that car for some reason didn't blow up after a mortar shot, which is, oh no, okay, it's on fire. Yeah, so you know, it's like, it has some fun elements, but I don't think it's enough to justify the full price, and it's definitely not, there's nothing innovative basically about it. It's like literally zero things. And there's a dead guy over there inside. What is he? He found more enemies, I guess, and just died along. Is that out? Oh, yeah, it is. There you go. Okay, there is still someone out here, but let's rest our friend. That helium, yeah. Yeah, this game also for some reason has the notion of making you hold the buttons instead of just pressing them once to do things. And I'm not just talking about, like, you know, actions that you don't want to do yourself, like swapping the weapon that you don't want to do accidentally, but also different other things like using ropes and so on and so forth, which is a bit weird. Yeah, using helicopter, you have to actually hold it to enter it. Okay, let me show you the view from the top. So as I said, the graphics in this game are really cool, and the map looks very awesome. So we can actually fly over the maybe that mountain over there. I don't know if that's actually inside the beta. No, it's not. Okay, damn it. No, please, no, I don't wanna. Okay, oh yeah, I see on the minimap now the area. Damn it, that's a bit unfortunate, because, you know, that looks really cool. I would want to go there and want to check out how it actually looks. The nighttime also looks really spectacular, but you know, unfortunately, we're now at the daytime, and I don't know if there's any way to skip it. I haven't seen anything like that, so cannot really show you that. But yeah, you know, it's again, it comes down to the question is whether you like games like this and whether you want more of that stuff, because it's again more of the same, or if you are a bit sick of it. I guess, you know, I guess I am at this point, because there's been way too much games like this lately. And you just maybe want to hold off a bit until it's, I don't know, 70 off, 60 off, 60% off, I mean. So, you know, you can just like buy it with a discount, and then maybe then shoot things with your friends. And because it's kind of fun, but again, you know, it's more of the same. That's what I'm trying to say. Yeah, so when you're on a parachute, it doesn't seem to have any fall damage or anything. You just drop down with any speed and velocity you can have. It won't matter much. So yeah, it's kind of nice arcadey tactical ish shooter, which is kind of fun, but I think it's just basically slightly overpriced for what it does. Maybe because, again, maybe because just I'm just a bit tired of games like this. There's way too many of them. Yeah, this is Ghost Recon Wildlands. Thank you for watching, and I see you next time. Bye.